My son Randy's favorite sandwich is a BLT. He'd have one every day for lunch if he could. So, to try to bring a little variety into his meals, I suggested adding some options to each part of the sandwich. For example, for lettuce, he could have iceberg or romaine. For the tomato part, he could have, a green tomato or a beefsteak tomato. And for the bacon, he could have, regular, extra thick or maple flavored. So, with those options to choose from, there are some questions you can ask. For example, could he go a whole week without having the same sandwich twice? Or could he go a whole month without having the same sandwich twice? And those questions all kind of boil down to the same thing. They're all asking how many different possible sandwiches can be made with these seven options. So the most straightforward way to approach this kind of question is to make a list. It's to list out all of the possible sandwich combinations. For example, iceberg lettuce, green tomatoes, and regular bacon. Iceberg lettuce, green tomatoes, and extra thick bacon. Iceberg lettuce, green tomatoes, maple bacon, and so on and so on. Try to finish out the list on your own and see how many combinations you come up with. Your final list should end up with 12 different sandwich combinations. Now, if your sandwich doesn't have those, doesn't have, if your list doesn't have 12, then you stumbled on the biggest challenge that we have with making out a list. It's easy to either miss an option and undercount the total, or include an option twice and overcount it. Now, one way to improve the accuracy of a list is to organize the options into what's called a tree diagram. Now, to create this kind of diagram, you should start with what it is you're trying to count. Sandwich options, in our case, that's the item on the far left-hand side of the tree. Then you draw lines or branches going out from there, listing every option in our first category. In this case, that's going to be the lettuce. So I've got one branch for the iceberg and one branch for the romaine. Then I'll do the same thing with the tomato branches. Coming off of iceberg, I'm going to put two more branches for the green and beefsteak options. Those are the two tomato choices. And I'm going to do the same thing down on the romaine branch. I'm going to add the same two tomato options. Then finally, we get to choose the type of bacon. And to do that, I'll add a final set of branches, one for each of the three types, and I'm going to follow the same pattern. I'm going to put one set of branches on the top green tomato, another set off of the beefsteak and the green, and finally the bottom beefsteak option. Now, to get the actual sandwich combinations, what you do is you follow along each branch. For example, if you go along the top branch of the tree, you get a sandwich with iceberg lettuce, green tomatoes, and regular bacon. And on this slide here, you see how I've written out all 12 of the options that by the trail of branches that generates it. And if you count, you'll see that I did, in fact, end up with the 12 options that I said we were going to. So this is the basic process for making a tree diagram. And but before we move on, I want to throw kind of one definition out here that's going to come up throughout the rest of our discussion. It's the idea of a sample space. A sample space is the list of all the possible outcomes for an event, an experiment, or a selection. In our BLT example, the sample space would be all 12 of the sandwich options that you have in the far right-hand column on the far right-hand side of the slide at the end of all of the branches.